And we meet together in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name through Christ our Lord. Amen. Remembering God's love for us and the forgiveness offered to all who truly repent, we bring before God anything that lies on our own conscience, anything that tarnishes the image of God in us, and we call them to mind. And together we say, Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we have sinned against you and against our neighbor, in thought and word and deed, through negligence, through weakness, through our own deliberate fault. We are truly sorry and repent of all our sins, for the sake of your Son Jesus Christ, who died for us. Forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life, to the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you. Pardon and deliver you from all your sins. Confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal, through Jesus Christ our Lord. In the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Please sit for our meal.
Different kinds of tongues are all apostles. all prophets, and all teachers, do all work miracles, do all have gifts of healing, do all speak in tongues, do all interpret, and even desire the greater gifts. This is the word of the Lord. In them he has set a tabernacle for the sun, that comes forth as a bridegroom out of his chamber and rejoices as a champion to run his course. The law of the Lord is perfect, reviving the soul. The testimony of the Lord is sure and gives wisdom to the simple. The fear of the Lord is clean and endures forever. The judgments of the Lord are true and righteous altogether.
To let the oppressed go free, to proclaim the year of the Lord's favor. And he rolled up the scroll, gave it back to the attendant, and sat down. The eyes of all in the synagogue were fixed on him. Then he began to say to them, "Today this scripture has been fulfilled in your hearing." This is the gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ.
Here's an epiphany.
if ever there was one, a showing of who Jesus is and what his priorities are. Here is a man who speaks extraordinary words with extraordinary authority. Jesus reads the scroll in a synagogue, just as we read the gospel in our church. And we are reminded that the communal readings of scripture is something that continues to bind us together and inspire us. Today, for Jews and Christians alike, as it has done for thousands of years, I wanted to emphasize the togetherness of Jews and Greeks, Jews and non-Jews, and Jesus' Jewish identity, because this Thursday, the 27th, is Holocaust Memorial Day. It's a day to remember the horrors of the Holocaust, in order that we can all work together and commit ourselves to building a world, to the best of our ability, where something so horrific could never happen again. During the Holocaust, Nazi Germany systematically murdered some 6 million Jews, two-thirds of the Jewish population of Europe. Over 42,000 camps, ghettos, and other detention sites were established. By mid-1942, victims were being deported from the ghettos in sealed freight trains to extermination camps, where if they survived the journey, they were murdered in gas chambers. I want to tell you about a film that I've been reading about recently. It's showing, apparently, on BBC4 at 10 p.m. this Wednesday, but presumably there'll be chances to watch it at a more holy hour. It's called The Final Account. The reason for the title is that many of the people with first-hand memories of civilian life during the Second World War in Germany are now dying. There won't be many more opportunities for those people to give their account. It's final in that sense. And the story of the man who made it, Luke Holland, itself is moving. He died in 2020, age only 71. It took him 10 years to make this film, during which he recorded some 300 interviews. Luke Holland was born in Ludlow in Shropshire and spent 10 years of his childhood in Paraguay. He then came back to this country. It was only as a teenager that he learned that his mother had been a Jewish refugee from Vienna, and that her family had been murdered in the Holocaust. In the last decade of his life, Luke took to the road with his camera in search of those who had lived in Germany and Austria in the late 1930s and 40s. He announced that he had no intention of dying. He lived another 5 years, completing his documentary masterpiece in the last month of his life. The archive of his film interviews will be held at University College London. What apparently is so chilling about the film is how ordinary everyone appears, how how easy it was to fall in to whatever people were told to do and told to believe. Extreme ideology is never very far away, as much within the church as without, as much in this country as abroad. Even how we express our views, I think, is important, let alone the content of those views. The more extreme the expression, the greater the permission given to others to be extreme in return. And for some, violence and deep rage is never far away. Sometimes small in scale, sometimes horrific in magnitude. Really good to read St. Paul today about how we are all one, Jews or Greeks, slave or free. Really good to remember Jesus in the synagogue on the Sabbath day, as was his custom, and to hear an account of him taking the scroll of the prophet Isaiah. Really good to remember, as if we needed reminding, that he was Jewish. Let us stand in solidarity this week with Jewish people all around the world, marking Holocaust Memorial Day. And let us work and pray for a world in which such horrors never take place again, and where faith and peace go hand in hand. Amen. To invite you, where possible, to stand and say the Apostles' Creed on page 6 of the Eastern. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Would you please sit for our prayers?
You'll be there for us.
Help us, Lord, be honest for those who trust us. Help us be truthful for those who care. Help us be strong for with much to suffer. Help us, Lord, be brave for with much to give. Help us to be humble, for we know our weakness. Help us to give and forget the gift. Help us, Lord, to be a friend to all, though the friend is. And above all, help us to live up and laugh and love and live. Lord, in your mercy, we place your hands, those who are sick among us, especially Stan Shackleton, Stan Kent, George, Mary Marshall, Mary Hiscock, Dorian Robinson, Maureen Mary, Margaret White, and her daughter Rebecca, Sue Hammond, Betty Quinn, and those who may and may not know. We pray, Lord, that you heal them in body and mind and spirit. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And those who mourn this morning, we pray that you comfort them. May the love and strength and peace and rest and glory, especially, Lord, your face and hands, Francis Carter, who have given so much to the community in Hackney. Who is buried in Friday. Bless them, Lord, and may they have a home with you. Lord, in your mercy. Our heart grieves, Lord, especially as parents, for the young ones who have been murdered in the streets of England. 14, 15-year-old. Don't think it nothing to take someone's life. Help us, Lord, to train our children in the way they should go. Help us to interact with them at home. Let them know that we love and care for them. Keep them in the vision of never take something from someone that they cannot replace. Lord, take away the hatred in their hand. And also, Lord, place the families in your hands. So many of them are children. We pray, Lord, that we turn their disappointment into something positive and the chaos into order. Lord, in your mercy, we also place, Lord, the governments of this world. Give us leaders of wisdom, humility, humanity. May they be prepared to stretch out the hands of friendships and neighbors. May they work towards a more sustainable, even distribution of the resources of this world, and above all, a more peaceful world. Father, I say these prayers for the sake of your Son, for the sake of Jesus Christ. Amen. God bless you all.
Always with you.
And also with you.
We offer one another a sign of God's peace. the same next hymn, our offertory hymn, which is number 622.
In the water made wine,
The new creation was revealed at the wedding feast. Poverty was turned to riches, sorrow into joy. Therefore, with all the angels of heaven, we lift our voices to proclaim the glory of your name and sing our joyful hymn of praise.
Thank you.
we break this bread to share in the body of Christ. The Lord we are living, we are one body because we all share.
Give a
family member a hug, tell a family member that you love them, and you were the winner of service in the you won this beautiful card. We'd like to give all of you a round of applause. A few notices for the week. There will be no evening prayer here in church today because we're joining with other Christian communities around South Hackney, and the service today is in Hackney Wick at St Mary's, and that's at 4 p.m. So no service here, but we're invited to St Mary Hackney Wick at 4 o'clock. Also, just because of Sean being away, on Monday I have to join a meeting, and so I'm afraid I won't be here for morning evening prayer on Monday. And also on Wednesday, I take my day off, but Sean is still away, so there won't be morning evening prayer on Monday and Wednesday, but there will be prayers on Tuesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. So just consult the calendar because we have some lovely people who join us in prayers, and I know it's harder when Sean goes away. The week of prayer for Christian unity continues until Tuesday evening, and those service times are in the calendar. We had a parish council meeting just this last week, and our plan so far is that we're going to review all our COVID arrangements for Sunday the 13th of February. So the church guidance hasn't yet come out, and the detail of the government guidance will definitely change this week, but we haven't seen the specifics of how it affects churches. But it should undoubtedly make a difference to us, and we're hoping that the 13th of February will be the first time we experience that difference. Happy Sinners meeting on Wednesday. I wanted to make note of my predecessor, Father Evan Jones's funeral. The date and time is now set. It'll be on the 14th of February here at 11 o'clock. The church where he was actually part of the staff was at St. Clement's King Square, and if it hadn't been for COVID, it probably would have been there, but it's quite a small church building, and there will be many people who want to come to give thanks for his life. So our church has been chosen as a church where he was a former rector, and also it's a wonderfully large church, so it can fit the people who'd like to come. So 14th of February at 11 o'clock, and everybody is welcome. I'll leave you to read the other notices. Just to say, on the 13th of February, our plan is that we'll resume tea and coffee. But in order to do that, we need to reconstruct our tea and coffee rota. So if that's something that you feel that you could do, that would be a huge help. And we'll start compiling a list at the back of the church. Even before COVID, our numbers on that rota were quite small, so it would be wonderful if we could increase the size of the rota so that everyone's duty day doesn't come around too often. So we'll begin to put that together. Are there any other urgent notices people would like to give out? In which case, I'd like to say a huge thank you to Matthew, who's been playing the organ for us. I'd like to give him a round of applause. And please stand for our final hymn, which is number 430.
Thank you.
Love and serve the Lord. In the name of Christ. Amen.